journey. The band that's persevered for almost three decades with fist-pumping rock for the boys. Tender ballads for the girls. Of course, Journey is synonymous with this guy. With his many Technicolor dream coats, 80s pop icon Steve Perry led the band to numerous Billboard hits. But he began his journey to rock greatness early on. Loving, touching, squeezing, and cruising his way through childhood. This kid was barely out of the sandbox when he met his future head-on.
I've been singing since I was seven. That's as far back as I can remember singing little tunes. But my grandfather tells a story that he had an old pickup. And I was standing up, I must have been about three or four, and I was singing with the radio. And he says he hit the brakes because something had jumped out through the car. And I went flying forward, you know, and cut my head. And his blood was dripping down my nose. It's just, I kept singing.
In school, Steve's talents really started to shine. He holed up in his bedroom with his drum kit under the watchful eye of the Beatles. It all paid off with his first quartet, the Nocturnes, who dropped a fortune on matching smoking jackets. Steve didn't really let his hair down until he joined the Sullies. These guys were gigging steadily enough at football games and proms to buy their own tour bus. The Sullies were going places.
My mom was managing us at the time, and she got us a chance to come to the Calaveras County Fair and compete in the Battle of the Bands. And the prize was Bill Graham would get us a gig at the Fillmore. I won it.
Steve was a star, but he can't take credit for starting the band. The seeds of arena rock greatness were sown here. In 1970, future Journey founders Neil Schon and Greg Raleigh were among the members of Santana's very intense, very hairy band. Greg and Neil couldn't see eye to eye with Carlos's artistic vision. Neil had the urge to rock.
When I was 15, of course, I used to get up every time I used to play the guitar. Now, you know, it happens a little bit less frequently.
Don't worry, it happens to all guitarists. Greg and Neil formed Journey and set about carrying on the Santana Afro tradition. As the band matured, Greg decided to move on, opening the door for Jonathan Cain, who was back with a very solid resume. That I've known you for such a long time. Behold the Jonathan Cain Band, singing their top 44 hits, till it's time to say goodbye on American Bandstand. These guys were just too earnest for their own good. Jonathan's group soon broke up, and after a stint with the Babies, he was Journey bound. Journey looks a whole lot different these days. Steve Perry's gone, and there's a new lead singer. But as long as there's butane left in the Bix, and the band keeps cranking out those classic hits, Journey fans will never stop believing.